To their clients, they were the friendly financial advisors, but hidden behind the smiles was the scam behind Russell and Alan Taylor's success. At court, the judge said they'd exploited the confidence of their customers to defraud them of their life savings.
They'd taken away all that hard work.
This woman, too embarrassed to be identified, lost half her pension while her husband was dying of cancer.
They were so ruthless to do that and not bat an eyelid or feel guilty because they needed a flashier car or boat or whatever it was they wanted.
On their website, the brothers had prided themselves on building relationships with trust and integrity. But from their offices on this tiny business park, they were misleading people into investing in an extremely high-risk scheme likened to betting on a roulette wheel. And what's more, because the brothers owned the fund, they were making money from it, something else they neglected to tell their clients. In all, they conned more than 200 elderly victims, investing more than £17 million of their money without their consent, using the profits to fund a lavish lifestyle, buying a boat, expensive watches and hiring a private jet. Meanwhile, customers like Gary Todd were receiving letters detailing their disappearing retirement funds. He's lost £20,000.
You just can't get it off your mind. It's on your mind all the while. Everything you've worked for, a lot of it has just been wiped away. I personally think it's greed. Enough's never enough for some people, and I think that's how that got.
Together, victims, including Gary, lost more than £5 million. But the way of life they funded for the brothers was replaced today with a combined 11 years in jail for what police have called a disgusting breach of trust. Ben Chapman, ITV News, Norfolk.